Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Derail Valley. I'm Nexxus, and today we're going to haul another load, perhaps unsurprisingly. This time we're going to go from the food factory to the machine factory town, and we're going to head out the way we're facing because I think that it may be the best way to get there, being that if we go down southeast, there's a switch, but we'd have to end up pushing the train backwards, and I just don't think that that's a good idea. So we're going to go through Iron Ore Mine West, and out the other side, and then down the way to the machine factory. So buckle up, put your seatbelts on, and enjoy the ride. All right, so I've almost connected up to the cars that we need to pick up. We just need to turn back on and get it all going. Actually, oh no, we're not within range. I would say we might be within range, but we're not. Let's not do it too much. Let's turn this all stuff off. On. Power up. Cool. All right, so we're going to grab those. And we're going to do this, push it forward, and we're going to take off. We're not going to use the steam engine this time. We're going to use the shunter just for, you know, obvious reasons. I want to see if the shunter actually drags me out of the engine and up the mountainside when we go through this tunnel up here, like it does with the steam engine, so that I can report it to the devs that it is a problem with apparently the steam engine. Anyway, directly following, not this episode, but directly following the next episode, I will be doing a tutorial on how to operate the steam engine. So if you're interested in that, be looking out for that. Make sure that you hit the red subscribe button on my channel and the notification bell so that you guys get notified whenever I post videos. I think we need to slow down a little bit here. We can turn the power off and just coast. Because if we go too fast through these switches, we're going to derail. Well, the cars are going to derail. Okay. So far, so good. I just don't want them to derail. Alright, must be going downhill a little bit or something because the power is off. Throttle's off and we're still coasting. Okay, now it's starting to make a difference. Okay. It's starting to level off. Or maybe the corner slowed us down. It looks like the corner slowed us down. I don't know if there's a hill coming up, so let's do this. Let's get some power going here. Let the station master know that we're leaving the yard. And we're going to be well on our way to the machine factory. Wow. I feel like there needs to be more tracks in this. Like, I feel like there's not enough. I feel like there's not enough tracks. As much as the map is not to scale. You can't look at that and be like, oh, that's not very big, because it actually is. But there just needs to be more stuff going on. Maybe it's the... And there needs to be, like, double track. Like, there should be another piece of rail. There should be another railroad track on the side of this one. Why are we having so many problems? This is not uphill. Like, what's the issue? It's only one load. Like, come on now. Don't start this crap. Got to use the sand because it's starting to become an issue. It's not even a hill. Like, what's the problem? I hope we're going to start going downhill a little bit. Because that would be incredibly helpful. There we go. Yeah, the whole wheel slip, that's kind of ridiculous, I think. We're not even going... You know, it'd be different if we cranked it into full gear from zero. Then I can understand the wheel slip, but just barely cranking it to halfway from 10? That's not good. I'd really like to know how the tracks look, folks. It's fine. Our speed's fine on this. Shouldn't be any problems. That should be fine, too. Should be good. 25 is decent. I'd like to go 40, if possible. We'll take this for now. I don't want to accidentally come up on a hill and then start crashing down the hill and then off the tracks and into the drink or, you know, the trees or the mountainside. I mean, the trains don't explode when they crash anyway, which is kind of unrealistic, but, you know, hey. Come on, come on, come on, come on. We should be good. What's the map look like? It's fine. We got that switch coming up. See how you guys are doing. How are you guys faring? Seems to be okay. Okay, so I read something. I think this was in, actually, it was in the I can't speak English today. I believe it was in the Derail Valley Discord that someone said that you don't actually have to validate the job when you take it from the station that you take it from. You only have to validate it when you drop the load off. Which, that's awesome. Because the whole time we've been validating the job at the station and then taking the progress sheet and then, you know, all that jazz. But apparently we don't have to do that. Apparently we just need to validate the job at the station that we drop off at. So we're going to test that out because I totally just realized that we forgot to validate the job at the station from pickup. So we're going to find out if it works or not to validate it at the end. That switch is coming up. Yep, devs, there's still some rocks in the tracks here. This is going northeast toward the iron mine. The iron ore mine west. Going west at the first switch toward the iron ore mine west. There's still rocks in the tracks. I know you guys are hard at work fixing and optimizing stuff. Just letting you know, there are still some trees and stuff. There are actually a couple trees still in the middle of the tracks, too, in a couple of places. Check it, 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 check it. Come on, little engine that could. This looks like a steeper corner, but I'm going to go ahead and... I'm going to go ahead and go with it. All right, so it's already set up to go the right way, so that's good. We would have had to slow down to hit that switch because it's a really sharp corner. But it's already set up to go the right way. To go the right way. Wow, that's a flat cliff. Never seen that before. Looks like we're good. Pretty sure we're okay. There needs to be a way for us to look at the map when we zoom in on the clipboard. Right now, apparently, there's not. But there should be. There needs to be. Also, the arrow keys on the right-hand side of the keyboard also work as you're up, down, left, and right. I didn't know that either. But I'd rather use WASD. I have a gaming keyboard, so they're red anyway. Those four keys are red. The arrows are actually red, too. Come on. How's this look? It don't look bad. We should be fine. Why are we almost in the yellow? I don't understand. The fan is on. Let's turn this down and just coast if it'll let us. Oh, it's going to slow down. I was hoping for a hill. Doesn't look like we're gonna get one though. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. I don't wanna slow all the way down. Oh, we're losing speed. There we go. You're still dropping, but the speed is still picking up. Or trying to, anyway. Hey, wow, come on. Why are you dropping so quickly? It's bullshit. We're not. Are we going uphill? That would really suck if we were. Looks like you're staying right where you're at, which is fine. Yeah, you need to pick up speed, bro. You need to kick it. You know, I'm going to kick you in your ass in a second. I'm going to turn the sand on and I'm going to go full throttle. All right, what are we looking like? I think we're good. More rocks in the tracks. I'm going to stand over here. Okay, so far we haven't been pulled out of the engine by the terrain or the tunnels. And I say that, and it's going to happen. Okay, so I have not been pulled out of the terrain or out of the terrain. I've not been pulled out of the tunnel by the terrain inside the shunter. It's only happened in the steam engine. Uh-oh. I can hear the stuff grinding. Ooh, that was a terrain glitch. If I've ever seen one. So, throttle's all the way down, and we're still picking up speed. So, we are kind of going downhill a little bit. And I don't know how well this shunter does on the high speeds around these crescent moon corners. It was used to be over 20 miles an hour and it would derail. The steam engine can take corners with a full load at like 60 kilometers per hour, and about 70 is when, a little over 70 is when they derail. And I only know that because I let the train roll backwards down a hill with a steam engine connected to about 16 cars and about 70 kilometers per hour in reverse. A little over 70, it was like 73 kilometers per hour in reverse. The trains all flew off the tracks. But, so I know the steam engine can handle a lot more than the shunter can, so to say. And we're almost at 40 kph. This is one of the tunnels that I got stuck with, actually all the tunnels that I went through with the steam engine I got stuck on. Okay, now I know why we're going so fast down this hill. And why we had so much trouble with the steam engine. Next time we use the steam engine coming out of that station up here, the iron ore mine west, we're gonna gun it out of the yard and hope that we don't derail on the switch going through too fast through the switches. That's the only way we're gonna get out, probably, of the area. This is all downhill. There's no throttle, and we're slowly picking up speed. Yeah, this is all going to be downhill. Which is fine. It just means that we don't have to waste any fuel. And the temperature is going down. Nice. Uh-oh. It says that a lot of the speeds have been fixed for the corners. But this shunter is a really, really small electric engine. I wouldn't imagine it'd be able to take too many, sharp turns at high speed. Everything capiche back there? Everything looks good. There's more rocks in the tracks, Dev. Ah, there's a big one coming up. Oh my gosh. I don't want to get pulled off the train. I really don't. Oh my gosh, probably might get pulled off the train anyway. Ooh, okay. No. Maybe not so much. All right. We should be good, but I want to check the speed. More rocks in the tracks, Dev. So far, I have not fallen through the ground either. But again, I'm not using the steam engine, and I haven't fully tested that. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oof. Okay, so I know that they were saying that the next update is going to focus on improvements and stuff like that, and improving the brakes on the cars. And that's desperately needed. Oh, I can hear the grinding. Oh my god, it sounds horrible. It's not that it sounds horrible. I don't mind the grinding because, you know, it lets me know that, you know, we're either going too fast or there's a chance that we're getting close to derailment. It's just, it's a scary sound when you hear it. It's a very scary sound when you hear it. Next tunnel. This is the one right before. Nope, this isn't. There's another one right before. Actually, this might be that long-ass tunnel that we had to go uphill. So if it's uphill coming the other way, then we should be going downhill. And it looks like we are. It's not really a big grade, but we are. It doesn't look like we're going downhill. We are, because we're coasting downhill again. Come on, come on. Keep it together, keep it together. That's the other thing. Slowing down for corners is great. Slowing down around corners, not so great. You're more likely to be thrown off the tracks if you try to slow down inside the corner like this. If you try to slow down now and throw the brakes, you're more likely to go off the tracks. You're better off waiting for a straightaway right here. And only the engine really needs to be on it. I mean, I could be wrong. That's just my experience. So because we didn't try to slow down a little bit back there on the straight, that little straightaway, we're going to have to just hope that we make it through the corner. Which we should be fine. We're only doing 30. But it is a little tight, and we're hearing that screeching noise again. It's the metal-on-metal grinding. Right now we're on the straightaway, so if we want to slow down a little bit, we need to do it now. And then pull off the brakes when we start to go into the corner. There we go. 25's decent. And this is a tight corner. Taking this at 40 would have definitely probably thrown us off. This next one's not so bad. And we're actually picking up speed again because this is all downhill. You can just barely see the grade. And we're still picking up speed again. Very slowly picking up speed. Let the iron ore mine west know that we are inbound down the mountainside. And that they need to clear track. They need to clear the tracks for us. Actually, where are we supposed to drop the stuff off at? Oops. Track 7. Okay. All right, track 7. And then if we look at the station map. So when we come in, it's the first to the left and then the second to the right. Oh crap, we might actually go off the rails here. That was close. And maybe it wasn't because they have fixed the derailment. It's just that I've been playing the game since like, you know, a couple days after launch. And so I've already experienced, you know, bad juju on the corners. So even though the new builds have tweaked the derailments, I'm still kind of nervous because I don't know what those, how much that they've that tweak has, you know, done for the speed and for, you know, the turning ratio to speed ratio. So I'm still a little nervous about it. All right, so we're going into a tunnel, so let's start to slow down a little bit because we're coming up onto the mine. And we don't want to barrel, we don't need to barrel through the station at breakneck speed. All right, so it said it wanted us to go where? To 7. I-7. And the station map says I-7 is, we're going to come in, we need to go forward, and then we need to take the first right, and then the second left. No? That's not right. Oh, yeah, it is. We're going. We're looking at the wrong friggin' map. That's what the problem was. Okay, let's start to slow down a little bit. We don't need to barrel through the iron ore mine station at breakneck speed. All right, we need to slow down a little bit more. Come on. The cars are so heavy and they're pushing us that they don't want to slow down. It's bad. Okay, so let's get the right station out. Machine factory, I-07. So we need to go, when we come in, we need to go left and then right immediately at the next one and then undock. And then we'll go inside and see if it'll validate our mission, even though we didn't validate it from the leaving station. Okay, we need to slow down again. All right, so basically what's going to happen, what we're going to do here is we're going to move. We're going to go through this station. We're pretty much just going to go right through the middle of it. I don't want to slow down too terribly much. I think 30 should be plenty fast enough to go through the yard. Now, later in the game, when new stuff gets added and AI trains and stuff get added, we'll have to watch out for other traffic on the rails. Because we won't be the only ones out here anymore. So it's really risky to start. It's a crescent kind of turn, so I'm not real worried about applying the brakes a little bit. It's not that I really want to slow down. I just want to prevent it from going any higher. Or any faster, rather. Yeah, this is that long-ass tunnel. Man, we've been in here for a minute. This is one of the tunnels, by the way, that was clipping me inside the steam engine and dragging me up the mountain. Right. Oh. Alrighty then. I think we're good. Everything's good. Hello, Iron Ore Mine West. Goodbye, Iron Ore Mine West. We need to slow down. Now we can take the brakes off. All right, you guys see these? Check this out. Look at this. You see this? Like, I don't know if that's a graphical glitch or what's going on, but it shouldn't technically be able to ride over that, and it does. So that's a little unrealistic. It's a little immersion breaking, guys. But you know, we're gonna trundle forward. And kick this into gear because I don't know what's coming up. I don't know if it's a hill or what. Looks like we might be going uphill a little bit. Come on. We are picking up speed a little bit. Could be doing a little better, honestly. Come on. We're halfway there. We're actually more than halfway there, honestly. We're three quarters of the way there. We need to take this left. I'm gonna be ready with the junction thing because I don't know which way that it's facing. We need to go left. It's probably set up to go right. All right. First thing is first, we need to slow down. Nope, we're set up to go left. But we do need to slow down. We don't want to go too fast through this switch. It looks like we might be able to handle it, actually. Of course, I say that now and we'll derail. All right. Yeah, it looks like we're going to be all right. We just need to... Yeah, this... Okay, I remember this place. This is this one. It's kind of a grade. Turn the sand on and kick it into higher gear because we need to climb. Yep, I forgot about that. All right, and then why is there another switch? I don't see that on the map. I'm gonna say that it's left. Guys, there is a glitch on the map. There is no switch that's showing on the map here. That, and there's that tree in the middle of the thing. So that should really be fixed. There is no indication that there is a switch there. That's totally butt cheeks. All right. I'm going to look at the map again, but I'm pretty sure there's no indication of a switch. There's one switch. We already went through one. So, where's the other one? Yeah, there's no switch there. That's butt cheeks, guys. That's bad. That's really bad. I don't even know. Maybe that is... Okay, that might have been a secret. That might be why there's nothing on the map. That might have been one of those secrets that I've been hearing about. There's like a... I don't know, there's a couple different things out there that I've been hearing about that I actually want to go check out and look for. And we might actually do that in one of the coming future couple episodes after the steam engine tutorial. Sometime after that, we're going to take an engine out. Just a little shunter with no cars. And we're going to go out and we're just going to ride the rails and, you know, check out all the lines and find out, you know, exactly where these kind of things could be. Because there is no indication of a switch right there. Look at that back there. There's only one and we went through two. So where's the other one? I think that was a secret track. to go out somewhere. And so I'm going to go, we're going to go explore that together. All right. We should be coming in fairly shortly. Yeah, we should be coming in right here pretty quickly. You guys are getting a little bit longer of an episode today because we're in this thing, so we're not picking up speed as fast as we would if in a steam engine. But the steam engine's having problems with the tunnels, at least for me right now, anyway. So let's let them know that we're coming around the mountain. Let's look at the station map again. So we need to go left, right. Okay. So we'll get this ready, but we won't pull it out yet. Oh, there it is. I can see it from here. Factories abound. They need this stuff that we're hauling, whatever it is. It tells us. Deliver cat food to the machine factory in town. All right, Callie, Sylvia, where are you guys at? I'm delivering cat food. I'll just put you guys in the factory and you can go to town. I'm talking to my cats, by the way. I'll just put you inside the factory and y'all could just, you know, just start tearing shit open. All right, so power down. Oh, we need to stop. We're going to have to back up. I already screwed it up. Already screwed it up because we weren't paying attention. We need to go left and then right. Right. So, let's back it up. Left and then right. Okay. So it's already set up for us to go right. It looks like that's track 7. Stop. Alright. Okay. Alright. Here we go. Come on. I don't even go faster than that. Get up to about 15 or 20 and then cut the throttle. Like that. Okay. This should be 7. No, 7's over there. What the? Oh, we came in from the wrong direction. Oh, my God. Okay, so we came in from the north. That's true, we did. I'm a dumbass. I wasn't even thinking about that. The fact that on the map. Right, exactly. Okay. What happened? Oh, I don't want that. Yeah, okay, yeah, we did come in on the north. My bad. Whoopsies. Okay, so I was right. So track 7 is over there. It's just, I mean, I was wrong. I was right, but I was wrong. I was looking at it right. I was just not, I wasn't interpreting it right. We did come in from the north. We didn't come in from the south. Otherwise, this would be track 7. Makes sense. Awesome. All right. Slowing down going backwards is different because it pulls on the cars to slow down. When you're trying to slow down forward, it's different because it pushes on the cars, which can cause the trains to go off the tracks. So we need to switch the junction. No. Don't need to do anything. That's it. It's a done deal. It'll put us right on the track we need to go on. I hope. If not, we'll be backing up again. This should be seven, though. The way I was looking at it over there, this would be seven. It looks like one of the main tracks, but it's actually not. Perhaps unrealistically, there's only one main track going through there, and it's this one that we're looking at. Everything else is a siding. Or a siding. Storage siding. All right, we're on seven. We're on seven! Where the hell is the office? Hopefully it's over there somewhere. I'm hoping. Ah, there it is. I see it right there. Set nicely between the two industrial buildings, the cat food factory and then the shipping warehouse, the factory and the warehouse. Maybe that's the factory over there. There's a bunch of, maybe it's all cat food. I mean, it's not all cat food, but that's what we're hauling is cat food. That's a hell of a lot of cat food. Six cars of cat food. Holy shit. I'm gonna wait until we pull just a little bit in front of the station. Make sure that the cars are all, I think they're all inside the siding. There was only six of them. We can start slowing down now. Good. Unhook. Power down. All right. Let's go inside. Moment of truth. Oh, they were right. It did validate for us. Damn, we missed the bonus time by 3 minutes. That sucks. It's all right, though. All right, thank you to the people in Derail Valley Discord who said that you did not have to validate at the station you pick up, just the one you drop off at. Oh, damn, look at all this stuff. We got all these nice cargo stuff to load and everything. Darn, that sucks. Then we gotta go back to the food factory. Oh my gosh. Some to the harbor, but oh, the steel mill. Nice. Empty flat cars to the steel mill. Woo! But unfortunately, that's gonna wrap it up, folks. I've been Nexus, and this has been Derail Valley. Thank you very much for watching this one. If you like what you see, give me a like and a comment. Hit the red subscribe button if you've not done so. Share these videos out. Hit the red note. Hit the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I go live. Thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.